Hello everyone. Today I'll be talking about how to create a hover animation allowing you to achieve such professional results. If you like more of these techniques, don't forget to subscribe and be sure to like so that YouTube can offer you similar videos. And if you're interested in making animations and motion graphics in After Effects, and you're still at the beginning of learning or even a professional, I recommend you to enroll in Motion Hero course, because in this masterclass I talked about all the necessary topics that pro motion designer needs with lots of practice and projects, so you have the fastest path toward perfection and you wouldn't have to do the same mistakes as I did. So enroll now and take your skills to the next level. Okay, without further ado, let's get right into it. Since I've created this animation using the Effector tool from the Duik and Genlois script, I believe it would be beneficial to begin by learning how to download and install this script. So please bear with me. Okay, to download Duik and Genlois, just Google the name first. Then click on Download Duik and Genlois, which will take you to their official website. Scroll down and click on this option. On the following page, you can download Duik and Genlois by clicking on this button. Once you've downloaded the file, simply extract it, navigate to the scripts folder and then to the scripts UI panels, and copy the Duik and Genlois file from here. Next, go to your After Effects install location and open the scripts folder, followed by a scripts UI panel, and finally paste the file here. After that, go to the Edit menu, then in Preferences, select General, and here click on Scripting and Expressions. Enable these three options to make sure your scripts and plugins work perfectly fine. Afterward, close and reopen After Effects for the changes to take effect. Now to run the Duik and Genlois, go to the Windows menu and click on Duik and Genlois. Okay, once that's done, before we dive into creating the hover animation, it's essential to learn how to use the Effector tool and the basics of creating the animation. This will help you better understand the process behind crafting this professional hover animation. So in the beginning, I want to make a hover animation for these three items, and then I'll get into a more complex one. The first thing that you should know is for a hover animation, we need two states. As you can see, I've already done that. The first keyframes are for the first state, and the second ones for the second state. And no matter how much is the gap between the keyframes, you can set the gap to 5 frames, 10 frames, or no gap at all, but I've set it to 10 frames. And I did the same for the rest of the items as well. After I've created two states for the items, I select them and hit U. Now let's use the Duik and Genlois and its Effector tool. I select the keyframes. I head over to the Duik panel. Then I go to the Automation and Expression section, and right here I'll be using the Effector tool. While the keyframes are selected, I click on the Effector tool. As soon as I click on the Effector tool, you'll notice a new layer called Effector and the circle appearing in the center of the scene. And all the values for which I created keyframes will turn red, indicating that they now have expressions applied. After that, when I select the Effector layer and move the circle, as you can see, the hover animation is controlled by this circle. And in the Effects Control panel, you can change the Effector influence range. For this, you can either make the circles bigger or smaller. Alright, once I'm done with the basics, I think it's time to talk about the professional one. Here, I do the same thing that I did previously. For this character, I create two distinct states. The initial state looks like this, while the second one, as you can observe, appears like this. If you look closely, this frame that's here fades, and another one appears instead, and a yellow background shows up as well. Also, the color of the text box changes too. The name of the character shows up using the scale. A reflection moves across the text box. And the character herself changes and looks up as well. And also the color of the hair, cheeks, and clothes change too. And all these changes make our character more vivid. If I show you the keyframes, you can observe that I've created quite a lot of keyframes to achieve this animation. I press F to close all the layers. Well, to control such animation better, I select all the layers associated with this item. And by hitting Ctrl Shift C, I put them in a new comp and give it a name like item 1. I go to the comp and right here I define the area of the comp like this. I move the indicator to see if the animation goes out of the selected area, which it doesn't. And that's good. Then I go to the composition menu and then select crop comp so the comp is cropped according to the selected area. After that, I hit the U button and go to the second keyframes. Exactly right here and hit the N button and trim the timeline from this point. I go back to the main comp and here I select the item comp. I hit Alt-Ctrl-T so the time remap would be enabled. As you can see now, the animation of the comp is controlled by these two keyframes. And in order not to hide the comp, once the indicator places on the second keyframe, I go one frame back and create a keyframe for the time remap. And I delete the last keyframe so the comp wouldn't disappear anymore. After doing this, everything else is quite clear. I select these two keyframes and head over to the doink and then click on the effector tool. After that, I go to the effects control panel and then I make the circle bigger, so the area in which the effector affects would be larger. I increase it even further so that when the anchor point of the effector gets close to the layer, the second state of the layer starts appearing. And I also make the inner circle bigger. A little bit more. It looks much better now. Okay, once that's done, I can now open the position properties of both the effector and the cursor. And parent the position of the effector layer to the position of the cursor, so that wherever the cursor moves, this effector moves along. Then I can easily hide the effector layer and move the effector by moving the cursor. Just as easy as that. You can do the same for multiple items and create such professional hover animations. Thanks for watching and don't forget to comment, like and subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay updated.